Complete the proof by placing the statements and reasons in the proper order. So I'm going to work through the process of completing a two-column proof. Given 2x plus 13 equals 4x minus 5, and we're going to prove that x equals 9. Now, when you have to write a two-column proof normally, you actually have to write out all the statements and all the reasons. But in this case, the way these proofs are set up, they're actually narrowed down for you. So you don't have to think of every single possible statement or every possible reason that you could think of. It's narrowed down, and now it's just kind of like a puzzle. I like to think of these statements as the edges of the puzzle. Usually, when you're putting together a puzzle, you do the edges first. So I'll put the given statement first, the 2x plus 13 equals 4x minus 5. And the reason is given. Then prove x equals 9. That's going to be the last statement. Don't know the reason for step 5 yet, so just leave that blank for now. Okay, now the next step in completing a puzzle or putting together this proof, I'm going to organize statements and the reasons. So the statements I'm going to put all together right here. So these are all the statements and the reasons I'll put up top, so they're kind of together too. So there are three statements left, 2, 3, and 4, and 4 reasons. So I'm going to see if I can put the statements and reasons together in a logical order to complete this proof. So the first statement, 2x plus 13 equals 4x minus 5. And the next statement, let's see, we could have either 18 equals 2x, but how would you get, let's put that there, how would you get from 2x plus 13 equals 4x minus 5 to 18 equals 2x? Is there one step that you can do to get there? Well, the 13 changed to an 18 and the 2x is gone. That's more than one thing. That means you can't go from this first step to 18 equals 2x. How about this next one? 13 equals 2x minus 5. Well, the 13 is still there. The 2x is gone from both sides. That's the only change. Okay, so that could be the next statement. Now, what is the reason? You have a 2x here, now it's gone. You had a 4x here, now it's 2x. Now, what's the reason that change took place? What happened is 2x was subtracted from both sides, so subtraction property of equality. Okay, next statement, let's try this one again. 18 equals 2x. Now let's see if there's one step that you can make to go from step 2 to step 3. The 13 changed to an 18 by adding 5. The 2x minus 5 changed to 2x also by adding 5. So 5 was added to both sides. This is the correct next step, and the reason is the addition property of equality. Okay, that leaves only one more statement, so 9 equals x has to go here. Now how do you go from 18 equals 2x to 9 equals x? Well, you divide by 2 on both sides, because 2x becomes x. 18 divided by 2 is 9. That's the division property of equality. And then x equals 9. Well, how did that change from 9 equals x? Now, the order was switched around. And that's the symmetric property of equality. Now here's the big moment. I'm going to hit check answer and see if that's all correct. It says correct, you're ready to continue. That means this proof is right. Now you can use the strategy that I used for every single proof in this course. Put the given information first, put the proof statement at the end, fill in the given reason, and then go through and organize your statements together and your reasons together, and then just work through the statements. Try different possibilities of the statements and see which one makes a logical one-step difference between the statement before the next statement. And if you can find a valid reason that that's correct, you know you have the correct statement and reason, and you just move through the rest of it that way, just like putting together a puzzle one piece at a time. Now, I would also suggest that if you're really having trouble with a proof, take a screen capture of the proof and email it to your teacher. tell your teacher which lesson it's from, and the teacher can see what you tried for a proof, and then the teacher could make suggestions on how to finish up the proof and help you out a little bit. Okay, so that's how you can work through these two column proofs within this course. Just do it one step at a time, treat it like a puzzle, and if all else fails, send a screen capture to your teacher so your teacher can help you.